Eight boys, eight girls. It's early in the morning, I got to grind some black pepper, and I got it in my damn nose. I wanted to show y'all. This is the little ceramic briquettes that I put in my, this is the same material that pizza stones are made from, and the ceramic. And we'll talk more about that in a little while after I have some pops. But first, we've got to, we're smoking at Brisket, and I've got the chimney lighting outside now. And let me go over something, because there's some questions I get asked a lot. This is a Maverick ET73. It's got a place for two probes, or one air probe and one temperature probe, or meat probe. I have two meat probes for it. Need to check your probes and check your Mavericks, because they can get off. Just sitting here on the counter, one probe is 1 degree off from the other. So stick them in some ice water, and it should get down to, 32 degrees. Okay, then we're gonna put them in some boiling water and check both probes and see how far off they are. And we'll have to make a note, like one probe's off this many degrees, cold and hot. So we're gonna do that. Let them come down for a second. I gotta get some other stuff together. Okay, both probes are off. One of the probes is reading 31 degrees, the other one's reading 33 degrees. So you see they got a little bit of swing to them in cold. Let's see how they do it hot now. Got some water boiling on the stove. We're gonna put them in here and see how they do. And you gotta watch when you do this. You don't wanna burn that wire. It only takes so many degrees. You wanna keep it away from the side of the pot. The fire, well, heat's coming up. Climbing pretty rapidly. One's at 196, other's at 188. Look, 206 on probe 2, 208, 204 on probe 1. So they're both coming up. Give them a second. Probe 2 is already at 211. Probe 1's reading 209. There you go, 212. 211. Now they're touching the bottom of the pot, so that's going to make a little bit of a difference. Not too much. See, it done stabilized now. They both at 213, touching the bottom of the pot. So they ain't off much at all. And that's good. That's because that's the temperature range we're going to be reading at, is that higher temperature range for our meat. So here we got our pack of brisket. I hadn't trimmed the fat. Most of the fat's on the other side. Don't trim it. It's going to help baste it as it cooks. It's two muscles here. You can see one muscle, and then it overlaps onto this other muscle here that it in a section like this. So there's a fat line that goes through there. This part, the flat, is going to cook faster than this point. Sometimes the point's even bigger. So you can either cut it in half now or cut it later. You have to cut it hot if you cut it later. This is fresh out the refrigerator. I'm not going to let it rest at room temperature, but I am going to cut, because this one's going to come off first. And this one's going to have to stay in there a little longer. So we're going to go ahead and butcher him in half right now. Okay, got that here. Now let's season it. If you put anything on it you want, I like salt and pepper only. It brings out the full flavor in beef. And I just ground this black pepper, so it's hot. No, that ain't gonna fly. Flip it over, do the other side, add him in, good. We're gonna cook this side up now, like I told you. Liberally apply this. just like you see. This is a smaller brisket. It's about 8 pounds, I believe. And you got to get this into meat, and you can feel the resistance. If you hit fat when you're going in, it's going to slip right in. But if you're in meat, muscle itself is hard to push in. I can feel it. See, it's giving me a fight going in. No fat. It's in the center. It's not going down, touch. It's poked through the other side of the pan. move out the way for a minute, boy. See, it hit fat at first. Now it's getting tight as it went in. It ain't in fat now. That's very, very important. That's going on the bottom, that's going on the top rack. It's real humid outside, and the air conditioner's on in here, so this lens liable to fog up like a fool. But that smoke is ready. I gotta get this stuff on now. Maybe I'll let y'all watch through the window. It may be better. That way the camera won't fog up as bad. We can talk about it later. Let me zoom out. Okay, now, watch. You like that? Was it good for you too? Good. Doggone nuts. Okay, so when you buy a brand new Weber, Smoky Mountain, it's going to run hot the first couple cooks until you set up that shiny new inside, that shiny porcelain enamel lined steel. So you need to run the water pan. after that, you don't need to. Even with the water pan at first couple fires, cooks, you're going to have trouble keeping the temperatures down low enough. And you may have to close off two of the bottom air grates all the way and just barely crack one. I mean, just a smidgen. Top vent got to stay wide open all the time. Don't ever choke it off. Unless you're trying to put the fire out and you close all of them and leave it alone and it's going to smother itself out because it's sealed that well. So why not use water in a water pan after that, after you've sooted it up a little bit? The water, it takes heat to boil that water and keep it hot. If you put bricks or sand in the water pan, filled halfway up with said items, that's like a pizza oven. It that's going to hold heat and help. Let's say if the wind starts blowing real hard, it's going to help the inside chamber to maintain a more steady temperature. Same way, let's say a cold front comes through when you're cooking overnight on it or something. So it's going to help maintain a steady temperature. Let me see if you record, you dumbass camera. Yeah, good. And I use these ceramic briquettes because I had them. I didn't have no play sand. The reason I say play sand, it's been cleaned and washed. So, and it's made for kids' sandbox. That way if they accidentally get some in their mouth, well, it might hurt coming out the other end, but it ain't gonna kill them, in other words, unless your cat played in it or pooped in it, and it's not gonna hurt them. That's why they got covers for the sandboxes, by the way, boy. Heating water and keeping it hot at smoking temperatures, which is 225 to say 245 or 255 normal temperatures, it's just wasting fuel. You got to crack your air vents open a little more to keep the chamber temperature up. Whereas if there's no water in there, you can crack those vents down and save fuel. The fuel will burn longer. So that's the reason. And if you're going to use sand or briquettes or bricks or whatever, you need to, you want something that more like sand works best. Okay, cover it with foil, heavy duty foil. Like I use two layers, covered, sealed up. And then after the cook's over, you simply remove that with the grease in it, throw it away, and the sand's still clean. You don't have to worry about it. Same way with the briquettes. People have asked me about electric and gas smokers. I tell you who's got an electric smoker, I think is, or it may be gas, is Tango Joe of Tango Spice Company. Y'all go ask him, because he's actually got one and uses it and seems to get real good results out of it. The only thing I know is certain brands require you to use their manufactured press wood pucks. One brand comes to mind, I forget which one it is, and you stack them in this little hopper or this little container, and it'll drop a puck in every so often. I think you got to tell it. I want it to drop a puck in every 30 minutes or whatever for this many hours. Now, you can oversmoke foods. So, best rule that I've come across is after 3 hours of cooking, I'm not going to put any more wood from what I just started. I had about 4 fist-sized chunks in that fire pan. I'm not going to put any more. And they're going to smoke long enough to get a good smoke ring. And they're going to last about 2 hours, and they're going to be gone, and then the charcoals can continue to burn. There is another brand that uses like little pellets. You fill a hopper with these compressed wood pellets. And you got to buy that stuff from the manufacturer. So if you're buying electric or gas smoker, make sure it's one that can use wood chips or something that you just buy anywhere, like hickory chips or whatever. You're probably not going to find one that's going to use chunks. You may can even modify it to use chunks. The problem with large chunks is if they ignite and catch on fire, it can overtemp the thing, and then it'll have to shut itself down on whatever kind of safety mechanism it got, because they got a thermostat on it like an oven, and you set it to that temperature and it's supposed to hold it. And the wood's just supposed to smolder. It's not supposed to catch a fire like what it's going to do in the Weber in a little while. It's not really. It's going to more or less smolder too, because we got the air choked back at the bottom. And that brisket, you don't really go by time. You got to go by temperature on the probes. Some people don't say, we don't need none of that. That's all a crutch. They just go by feel and touch and look and smell. Well, I guess you do that too, but I'm going to go by temperature. I'm going to take it up to about 195, 196 internal. And then it'll be ready to pull off and let rest to slice up and do whatever we're going to do with it. A rough period of time is about an hour and a half per pound at 235. I'm going to be smoking this at about maybe 245, 250. You don't want to go any higher with a brisket. You can ruin it, make it too tough. And if you pull it too soon, like below 195, it's going to be tough. It tenderizes out after all that congealed fat and the muscle tissue does all this cool stuff internally. I think I've talked enough. I know I've made a bunch of other videos on this subject. Y'all can go watch those. Smoking 101 or Barbecue 101. I got a playlist on my main channel page of some of those tips videos that I've made. I just threw this in here. I may chop it out. I don't know. We'll see. Okay. Good. Something else just came to mind, and I figure I better add before y'all start asking. What if you wanted to smoke, say, a butt in a brisket? One's going to have to come off for the other one. A general rule for a butt is 2.5 hours a pound, and a brisket is 1.5 hours a pound. How about, like, if I, later on I want to go put a chicken on that smoker? Well, the brisket's already got all the smoke it needs, so if I put some more wood in there to give that chicken some smoke, it's going to over-smoke the brisket. That's why you'll see people, especially at barbecue competitions, they'll have 3 Webers or 4 Webers out there. And on one of them, they'll do chicken. They'll start it last. The chicken don't take as long as the brisket or the butts, so ribs. See, so you would use different smokers for different applications. So if I wanted to do a chicken, I'd have to go use another smoker. Otherwise, I'm going to over-smoke the brisket that's on there now. Offset smokers are fuel hogs. Unless you've got a huge one, like a big Lang or a big trailer-mounted rig, where the metal is so thick, it holds heat like a giant pizza oven. They still require a lot of tending to the vents and things like that to maintain temperature, because they're normally not sealed up as well as what that Weber is. The my offset's made out of good heavy metal, but it would take 4 times the fuel to do this smoke. And what I put in that thing, I didn't count the briquettes. The charcoal, well, I used Kingsford. I didn't count them, but I used about a little over a half a fuel load in there. And that's going to give me a good, I don't know, at least 14 hours if I needed to, but it's going to be ready before that. I just know. Especially being as I cut them in half. Now I've got 2 smaller roasts, and if it was 8 pounds, it's going to be 4 pounds. So 1.5 hour a pound, do the math yourself. I guess in weight, I probably put in maybe 8 pounds of charcoal. But as you a good rule, 8 pounds per pound of meat. I mean, 1 pound of charcoal per pound of meat. If you're gonna be smoking, but you can't put in 1 pound with 1 pound piece of meat. It's gonna burn too quick. And never mind. Hey, let's not go there. So we're gonna have brisket. I don't know what sides I'm going to make. Probably just potato salad, beans. I don't know. Maybe I'll make a dessert. Maybe I won't. I want some more of that lime ice cream pie. That's what I'm going to make. Yum.
Okay. The, how you call it, whatever the hell I'm cooking, I've been going. Oh, shit. Like I told y'all, since I cut them in half, they're going to cook faster because it's smaller roasts. When I put them on around 7, it's about 3 now. One of them's at 195. The other one's at 199. I'm sorry. One's at 198 and the other one's at 199. Something like that. I don't remember. Come on. You want to go out there? I bet the camera lens will steam up. Cause it's humid like a bitch. The smoke have been holding. It was at 250, but I cut all the air vents off on it, top and bottom, to choke it. Cause the brisket is ready. Let's see what it say. Yeah, look, one's at 200, the other one at 197. So they're ready to come off. Let me go on and get something. The dogs is all nervous. Come see this. What this dumb one here done did. Kind of like, you see how she, look. Go run around, stupid. She run around like that right there and wearing a ditch down in the grass, killing all my grass. She was a stupid dog. You can't have this, it ain't good for you. She says, that's bullshit. See, you got an air conditioner running right here. It's running, I see the fan look like it's running slow, but it ain't. It's the
frame rate on the camera.
Looking like it's gonna rain a little while. Oh well. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these briskets off of there. I gotta go get a pan. Put them in, I'm gonna wrap them in foil and put them in a warm oven just to keep them. You could also put them in an ice chest. Oh look, you can see me in the smoker. Look, oh, now what you think of that? The reflection. I had comments about that. Oh, did you wash your hands? No, I had my blue jeans on, boy. Pay attention when I'm talking to you. Hoss. That dog definitely paying attention.
Wood down here. Come out the way, chimney. To put the lid on. For the smoker. Probably smell good in there, huh? Unplug the Maverick. We don't need it no more. Get your pan.
Get you some welding gloves, or you can buy you some of them rubber pork pulling gloves. I got them too. We're just gonna use these for now. Put the fingers in the right hole, boy. Pay attention when I'm talking to myself. So go ahead, don't get the wires all tangled up. Yep. Y'all come apart now. And I only use these gloves for smoking. So pick up the food and the smoker tray and invert it. Just like that. Can you see down there, boy? A good. Now we're going to get that point off of there. It's down underneath and it's ready too. See up in there? Don't that look fine?
Just like that. Turn loose Maverick probe. I'm going to reassemble this thing.
And being as I got all the vents closed off, it's gonna extinguish itself. And we can reuse some of those coals for another cook. Meanwhile, I'm gonna wrap this up tight and foil and go put it in the oven and just keep it warm. The foil ain't no crutch. We don't really need it for anything other than keeping it from cooking any longer. How do I wash my grates? I'll show you in a second. I ain't gonna cook, I ain't gonna clean them today because we got people coming over and I gotta get all this brisket ready to eat. All right, here we go. The inside, Miss JB trying to kill me over there. You get your meat probes out. I'm gonna get a couple stills of these before I wrap them up tightly with this foil. Alright. So, we're gonna make some poking beans. And you can drain this silly stuff that come out of that can out of there. Or just put it in there. It's up to you. It's kind of a flavor stretcher. It really got little flavor at all. It's most likely some kind of jizz stock. I got no idea what it is. Get you a, see this one is a base barbecue sauce. So in other words, it's a base for making your own flavor of barbecue sauce. And we're gonna add some of that into here. Now, we got a base. To go along with whatever kind of base they had in there. It said poking beans, didn't it? Yeah,
put some of that smoked ham in there that you made the other day. Now is really poke in beans. Put all that in there too. You can slice it up, dice it up, wop a chopper, I don't care what you do with it. That's for my doggy. Like that. And it's a double burler. So we're gonna go ahead and get them warmed up. The ham's already cooked. All you gotta do is cover it, bring it to a boil, let it get warm. Next we'll make us a tater salad. Down there, boy. All right, so I got some cold water with some potatoes and some eggs in there for potato salad. Put them in the cold water, the eggs I'm talking about, and they won't crack. You put them in hot water, they're gonna crack. Then you're gonna have, poached eggs. Yeah, you don't want that. Now I'm gonna put a little bit of salt in here, simply for the potatoes' benefit, not for the eggs. It's a cackle fruit, and ain't gonna get nothing inside of it until you crack it open. Imagine that.
Let's make us a little tater salad. I done peeled up some cackle fruits and some taters. And put some mayonnaise in there. Get you some mustard. You want to make it German style, put whole grain mustard in there. I ain't got none. Send me some. You want to make it more Cajun style, put you some raw... How you call it in here? How you call him? This is pickle relish, by the way. Celery's, yeah, celery's. You can put all kind of shit in here. Plenty of salt. Just salt for a while till you get arm get tired. Put garlic in there. Put if you want to make it German style again. Put vinegar, sugar, bacon grease, all that good shit in there. So we got them eggs, them cackle fruits. Just bust all this shit up. Now you're supposed to have, how you call it's in here too. What you call them son of bitches? Onions, yeah. So, put all them in there also. All right, boy, let's see what we got here. Looks like we got some brisket. That's yum looking. So let's get us the flat out. See over here? Salt and pepper flat. Put him on a cutting plate. And you see how him come out. That's all the fat right there on top. You won't get rid of that? You do it your damn self. That's how him come out. Beautimus. Juicy. See that juice coming out of that meat? Can you see? Look down there, boy. See when I'm slicing on all that juice? Beautiful, beautiful brisket. Let's see. Watch. This should test right here. The pull test. Oh. Look. It just pulled right apart. If you want,
slice him up and eat it on bread. Sliced bread, it don't matter. Man, that's melting your mouth good. Yum. There ain't no sauce on that. Just salt and pepper. Give me that burnt end right there. Look at that. Man, that's some flavor in there. Yeah, boy. Oh, my God. Yum. Yum. Perfection. You want sauce? Put it on your plate. I don't need no sauce. That's plenty good enough right there. Oh, hell yeah. Some of y'all ask me, how do you clean your grates? I put them in a sink with hot soapy water, and as I'm putting the water in, I'll be spraying down on them grates like that. And we're going to let them soak in that hot soapy water for a while, a couple hours. Then we'll come and rotate them, and this is a deep compartment sink. You got one big enough to do the whole thing in, do so. And it ain't going to get everything off, but it's going to soften it up. And then you go get one of these paint. This is a stainless steel paint removing brush. It says Workforce on it. You can go get it at the home improvement store. And don't scrub your face. Don't comb your hair. Don't be stupid. And pay attention when I'm talking to you, damn it. So, after you done rotated them, drain the water out of there. And wrench them off again with the spray nozzle. See, look, spray nozzle. And then you're going to have to scrub on them to get all the stuff off. The stuck-on stuff. And all that brown shit will come off of there, or most of it. Then you just put it in your dishwasher and let it finish up. And if y'all are new to Weber Smoky Mountains, I suggest, and you bought a new one, read the manual that come with it and follow that direction for the first couple times, and then watch my videos of using the Weber Smoky Mountain. A boy and girl too. Okay, look, I'm in stereo. Put on headphones. Check it out. See if I'm behind your head right now with headphones on. I wanted to test that theory. Come here, boy. Why? That brisket was melt apart. Just delicious. Slice them up. A couple of the slices look dry because we left them set out while the grandkids and everybody was eating. But, oh, man. Hey, they rocked. Just tend to just fall apart. We'll have it again tonight for leftovers. Sorry that the video was so long. If you don't like it, tough. Go somewhere else.